the challenge is in front of you, do you accept it? I hope so. Keep the game on. Play the challenge. It's solo challenge, Matt Ultimate Team. The Titans offense set to go on first and 10. Defeating the Madden Ultimate Team solo challenge. Challenge awaits. Can you fulfill that solo challenge? Time to find out. It is indeed the solo challenge, and it's Madden Ultimate Team time. And the offense readies for a first down and 10.
Sometimes called just straight ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot.
Thank you. of the Vikings now as they get set on first down and 10. On first and 10, here's Vick. Dropping it off for Jackson. And he goes out of bounds just short of the 45. Back-to-back 11-yard gains, and they've got another first down. Whatever the discussions were at halftime, they're trying to slow down this offense. It has not worked to this point.
You have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds and being erased off of the Microsoft surface tablets because none of it is working. They're really locked in on offense.
And he gets us to the other side of the field across the 45 before going out. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. And so far, a very nice, methodical opening drive.
This has to feel like a scripted drive that they rehearsed perfectly all week long, and now they're executing it on game day.
Scripted, it's good so far. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time, and a first down. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area. But they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
To throw, Vick. They'll throw underneath for Gurley. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Bend the pressure and get rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And with a blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football.
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Solo challenge. You did it. You defeated it. Congratulations. We'll see you next time. They're getting set to go on offense. First and 10.
Something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Took the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have back on their heels.
From the 21, it's second and 10. Throwing again, Vick on second and 10. Forced out to his left. That is knocked away and incomplete. The All-Pro linebacker Luke Kuechly right there on the coverage, stride for stride.
10. I would expect to see some pressure here. This goes to the goal line. You have to be very careful with the offense called rub routes. When I call a pick, trying to screen you off from the coverage, does a nice job of avoiding that and helping force an incompletion.
The pressure drops off as they look to throw. So that does it. Put this one in the books. A successful Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge. See you next time. So the challenge is laid out in front of you. Can you complete it? We're about to find out. Solo challenge, Madden Ultimate Team time. Let's go. Here come the Jets now as they get set to go on first down. On first down, it's Donald. And his first pass is incomplete. Ah, too bad. Can't win them all, though. Come back, try again. Getting set, first and 10.
There we go now.
On first down, Donald. And he will lose yards back to the 34-yard line. All right, nice job. I believe that is challenge met and defeated from where I sit. Congratulations. Good job on this Madden Ultimate Team solo challenge. Getting ready on second down. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. From the 26, they'll line up on 4. Vic on second down. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football.
Excellent read right there. Soft cover one. That means it's just a single high safety. So you know if you throw the ball to the outside part of the field, help is going to be a little bit less. and he puts one out there for a big-time completion.
So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. Nick operating on first down. He's going to flip one out here to his right hand. For this one, pat yourself on the back. You just completed and dominated the Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge. Ready for a first down and 10. And it's back to by the ground with Johnson. Just a yard of the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
On the ground, this is Johnson. They'll get this up over the 25 and the 26. It's a gain of 6, moves him to a manageable 3rd-and-2 situation.
He was hoping to get to the edge, but they did a really nice job of forcing him back inside. That's excellent fundamental defensive football. Don't let him outside, but with a really stretch of defense.
And the second wave of tackles is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4.
I mean, I saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers reading the play and failing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
Carry here for Johnson. And room inside the 40. Chris Johnson in the front race, and they will not catch him. Nice job. Congratulations. Defeating the Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge. offense gets set here now for a second and goal. Second down, Vic. Steps away to his left. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Delaney Walker, a beast in the red zone with his second touchdown of the game. And the Titans take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? And, you know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air. Because right now, we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's two touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
Hey, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like when you flip that over.
You know, I just grab the nugget when I can.
And he's got it. The conversion good, and we are tied in the fourth. And that does it for this Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge. You did it. You defeated it. Congratulations. We'll see you next time. Saw the challenge on the screen. I don't need to repeat it. It's Solo Challenge, Madden Ultimate Team. Go earn your key. The Titans offense set to go on first and 10. Throw on first down. Throw left side, taken in by Hill. And he gets a big number. And he finally goes down at the 23-yard line. A big play there on the catch and run. 58 yards. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far on the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. Now here's Vic. Buying time to his left. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Carter, we talked about this at halftime, but I don't think either one of us expected it to continue. Michael Vick has been bottled up in this game. This defense has done a fantastic job of containing his running
board. It is so good. They could never contain him back in the year. Remember 2006 when he set the single season record for over 1,000 rushing yards. Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
The throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your left pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you can't have nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that. It's Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge. You know the drill. Let's get right down to it. And now the offense getting set. First and 10. Fifth down. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Titans, 57 yards.
The goal for any offense versus his own defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball in the receiver before any defender can step up your foot.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. Now here's a pass on first down. It's knocked away and incomplete.
I would say it might be a good idea for him to reintroduce himself to his receivers at the half because they've got them on different wavelengths. But I also don't have to keep waiting that long. Next series before you get out there. Hey, let's get together, guys. Let's get this thing moving.
A second down throw for Vic. Alluding to pressure right. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and it's taken down. Nigel Brown in there a second for a loss of six.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, Depp has been a constant duress this entire game. I'm not out of surviving that yet.
And you think there's still a long way to go in this football game. Able to find Harris complete. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. That catch was not so immaculate, but it does move the sticks.
Oh, I hear what you're doing right there. You talk about Franco Harris, one of the all-time great catches in NFL history. The immaculate reception. Franco, a four-time Super Bowl champ, they helped contribute to that game against the Raiders.
Finished his career with 307 catches. I think he's... And he will score! Touchdown, Titans! Delaney Walker from 4 yards out. And the Titans take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive.
That appeared like any routine NFL quarterback, but it was Michael Vick from the pocket, throws a touchdown pass. I just think about the transformation throughout his career. From Atlanta, where he would take off and go at just about the drop of a hat and turn defenses into mush. And then by the end of his career in Philadelphia, where he completed pass like we just saw from the pocket, yet still had those great legs, when necessary, to help get him out of trouble.
Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And that will get him one closer. So that about as lengthy a drive as you're ever going to see. And the result in the end, the Titans touchdown. So here comes the kickoff, and what now is just a one-score, six-point game. Now we take it in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. So now here comes the Eagles offense as they get ready to take over. As we get a peek at the number 2 overall pick from the 2016 draft, standing at 6'5", Carson Wentz.
Not only does he look good, he plays it as well. Tall, prototypical-looking pocket passer with better athletic ability than what people think. He's outside of the pocket and makes big plays downfield.
First drive, they're being aggressive, slinging it around.
Really confident, too, because they're not trying to fool them with running plays, throwing it, and it being very successful right now.
On second down, Smallwood. 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they move the ball with relative ease.
First and 10 at the 36. This offense on the march right out of the gate. They'll run it now. Out of bounds. They'll take this one for about a 4 up to the 40.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
On second down, here's Wentz. Taken down at the 46-yard line. That Eagle first down, Wentz hooking up with Jeffrey.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
On first and 10, here's Wentz. Throwing in the middle, and it's incomplete. Golden Tate, his intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. Not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it. And he gets those shoulders right, that pass will go from incomplete to complete.
And they set up the screen. That's complete. And now the ball's out. Fumble near midfield.
Let's face it, everybody at the start of the game has a mental image of how they expect it to go. Exactly as they scripted it offensively. Moving the ball well, seemingly in control. And that fumble, that's got to be a little bit deflated, don't you think?
Foil the whole plan there. Turn the ball over. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. First half, it's been fun, back and forth, back and forth. Well, it's not fun for the defensive coordinators, but offensive coordinators are enjoying it.
Yeah, they're having streaks here, aren't they? Being able to put scores together and really bunch them up, and we have a tight game here. You know, we often talk about having the right shoes for the right